Hi, I'm Ayo Tunde Balogun. Here's your Channels TV Evening News Recap for June the 19th, 2020. Governor Godwin Obaseki has formally joined the People's Democratic Party in Edo State. The governor, who dumped the All Progressives Congress earlier this week, picked up his PDP membership card at the party secretariat in Benin City, the state capital, today. His decision to join the PDP has finally put pay to the suspense regarding which party he would move to following his resignation from the APC. Meanwhile, the Federal High Court sitting in Benin City has adjourned to Monday, June the 22nd, for adoption of processes in the suit challenging the planned mode of primaries of the All Progressives Congress ahead of the Edo governorship election. The suit filed by Kenneth Asekome and Matthew Idori-Ekenwe against four defendants is challenging the direct primary method the APC plans to utilize. Another application by parties seeking to be joined, filed by Osage Zeyamu, Pius Udubu and Osaro Obaze, was dismissed, but the parties have decided to appeal the order. Staying with legal matters, the Chief Justice of Nigeria, Tanko Muhammad, has charged the President of the Court of Appeal, Justice Monica Dongban Mensem, to discharge her duties without fear or favour. The CJN gave the charge after swearing in Justice Dongban Mensem into office today in Abuja. Moving on to health, the federal government has released 4.5 billion naira to 31 federal teaching and medical centers across the country. According to the Minister of Labor and Employment, Dr. Chris Ngige, the sum is to cover hazard and inducement allowances for health workers for the months of April and May.
So we have expended 4.5 billion as we speak this morning for these payments.
On the international scene, China has charged two Canadians with spying more than 18 months after they were detained. Michael Kovrig, a former diplomat, and Michael Spava, a businessman, have been held in China since December 2018. Their arrest came just days after Meng Wanzhou, an executive of Chinese Huawei, was detained in Vancouver at the request of the US. And that's your news recap for today. Do join us tomorrow for fresh updates. I'm Ayo Tunde Balogun. Thank you for watching.